Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo. Watch the video till the end, and also if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon. Friends, today we're going to learn a concept which is known as net tangible assets. Now this is a part of a balance sheet, this component. As you can see over here, there is a thing that is visible in front of us. Net tangible assets is your total assets less your intangible assets. Now, we need to first understand what is tangible and intangible. See, tangible assets are the ones which is visible. But in case of intangible assets, it cannot be touched, nor it is visible, but it exists. So, when you deduct from the total assets, the intangible part and the total liabilities part, you receive your net tangible assets. Let's understand this in a complete detailed format. Now, first and the foremost thing that we are going to learn is what are the net tangible assets? This is the first question. See, net tangible assets is basically an accounting term. It is, you know, alternatively known as the net asset value, or it is known as your book value, which we call as NAV or BV. So it can be calculated by taking your all the total assets of the business. You subtract the intangible assets. I'll write for you the total assets less any intangible assets less any liability, less liabilities. That will give us your total or your net tangible assets. Net tangible assets. Right. Now, intangible assets over here, it includes something like this, like, you know, goodwill, you have patents, you have trademark, right? You have the par value of preferred stocks, and, you know, also you need to remove all the liabilities to arrive at this figure. Now, what exactly is the net tangible assets formula? See, the net tangible assets formula is what we have seen over here. Now, here, the total assets, we'll discuss each component separately. The total assets over here is the sum total of the asset side of the balance sheet. It includes all your current assets over here. Then we have the long-term liabilities or the long-term tangible assets. We have also over here intangible assets and so-called goodwill. Right. Now, this was the part of explanation for the total assets. Now, what about intangible assets, which is the second part of our formula? See, this assets are the those ones which we cannot touch or feel. Like an example, goodwill, trademark, copyright, patents, and so on and so forth. What we need to note here is that the most balance sheet reports goodwill separately, right? And from the intangible assets. So in our net tangible assets formula, do not forget to take the sum total of both. You need to take care in that regards. The third component is the total liabilities. Now the total liability, this includes, you know, your current liabilities and the long-term debts. Right, and the other long-term liabilities. Okay, so this are the part of the total liabilities. Now let's understand the net tangible assets example. Let's say, suppose there's a company called KG Inc. Right, and it has a total asset which is worth, let's say, 1.5. Everything over here is going to stay in terms of million on its book, and has the total liabilities which is standing closely worth 200 million. There's 1.5 million in terms of assets, the total liability is standing at worth of 200 million, and the intangible part is, let's say, standing somewhere close to 500 million. So, then after subtracting both from the total asset, the net asset would stand at 800 million, right? So, let's understand this with the help of an example of Starbucks. I'll show you an example over there. Now, this is the extract from the Starbucks data of 2017, there are a couple of details of total assets over here, current liabilities over here. As you can see, the total assets which is standing in 14,356. So let's do one thing. Let's copy this image and let's practice this one over here so that we have clear idea exactly what we are learning. Now, the data is right in front of us in Excel. Let's try and calculate a couple of things. The total assets that is visible to us, which is standing at 14,356, right? 365, I'm sorry, 0.6. The total intangible assets, which is standing somewhere close to, we need to add up two things over here. The other intangible assets and the goodwill part. So we'll have total amount standing at 516.3 plus 1539.2, because we have to add the goodwill amount also. So that comes down to one. Sorry, this is not 516. It's 441.4. So that comes down to 1980.6. And our total liabilities will be standing at 8908.6. So let's calculate the Starbucks example over here, and we'll calculate the net tangible assets with the help of what we have learned. Well, our total assets is 14,365.6, right? We need to deduct any intangible assets less the total liability, so 3476.4. Right, so this was the case for 2017. Now, in the similar fashion, we'll take the number for 2016. So we have a comparative data. The total asset that was standing was 114,312.5. Right, the net tangible assets will be is equal to 516.3 plus 1719.6. And the total liability will be 8421.8. So the net tangible assets is going to be the total assets less the, okay, just transfer this formula here. So 3645.8, and it has reduced for 2017 through 3476. So after learning this example, I want you to understand what exactly is the significance of the use of the NTA. See, the measure is considered very useful in the analysis of companies' assets, but their level of relevance might be different for any industry. Now, one might be dealing with, the relevance of the NTA is largely dependent on how important intangible assets are for a specific industry, since they are taken away while calculating the measure. See, in case of the oil and gas companies, or the car manufacturer, NTA are really very high. They are high because they can secure debt financing relatively easy by pledging their tangible assets. Second, in the tech sector, in the technology company, intangible assets, ITA, are pretty high. They are pretty in the large quantity because this results in lower amount of NTA. Because tech companies are mostly using the softwares and so on and so forth, the other things which the intangible portion in tech companies are really very in the high proportion level. Now, what we need to learn next over here is the net tangible assets per share. See, this measure is used in place of the NTA, that is the NTA per share. It is useful for comparison of the companies they are operating within the specific industry. So this is because the different industry tend to have widely varying ratios of tangible assets and tangible assets, and hence the relevance of this measure absolutely differs. So net tangible assets per share are calculated by dividing the NTA figures by the total number of shares of outstanding for a company. Okay, so the net tangible assets formula will be per share, will be the NTA per share will be is equal to your NTA divided by the total number of shares. So this is it for NTA, for the tangible net tangible assets.
So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.